Welcome, Geminis.
I am the Empress. I'm happy to have you here with me today. We're going to go ahead and jump into 2020. I'm sorry I didn't get you guys this December out, but that's why I'm trying to jump ahead now and get you guys this 2020 coming in, you know, that energy coming in. I definitely apologize. I'm going to do you guys this first. Okay, we're going to do Geminis first, all right? So let's see. I'm very, very interested. Keep in mind, guys, these are general reads. They won't resonate with every single Gemini. All right? Energies can go vice versa. So let's take a look and see what messages are there for Geminis. What message is there for Geminis? Give me an overall message for Geminis for January 2020. Give me one more card for Geminis. Okay, yes. All right. Look at you. Oh, yes. You're making a decision to walk away if something does not no longer serve you. If you aren't getting any positive energy from it, you're deciding to walk away from it. We have universe. Okay, so this is the closing of a cycle. A cycle has ended. Okay, you are looking back over your past. What no longer serves you, you're done with it, okay? You're closing chapters, okay? And you're making a decision, okay? There's like a choice. Either I'm going to stay stuck in the past or I'm going to move forward. I feel like you are deciding to close chapters, okay, and move forward. So let's see. We have emotional loss. We have solar plexus chakra, and we have firm foundation. Okay, so I feel like a lot of you guys, let's talk about this. I feel like the energy for you guys going into 2020, you may be looking back over a situation, looking back at that past, okay? And there's things that you're tired of, that you were ready to put down, could have been habits, could have been anything. You were possibly looking at a situation like with regrets, okay? Looking at a situation like, you know, woulda, coulda, shoulda, crying over spilled milk. But this is past energy, okay? So something here about that past that you are most definitely thinking about, you know, I kind of regret doing it, or I kind of regret saying that. Presently, this is your energy, solar plexus. Now, with your solar plexus, okay, this is saying that, you know what, the key word for solar plexus is I can. Okay, so you're looking at everything that you can change, looking at everything that you could, you know, what you don't know, no longer need, and looking at more focused on the things that you can change, the things that you can do for 2020, okay? The changes that you do want to make for 2020. A lot of you guys are going to be focused on building a firm foundation. You're planting seeds, okay? If you've been planting your seeds in 2019, I feel like a lot of you guys' focus is on meditating and figuring out, visualizing exactly what it is that you want to bring in for 2020. And I feel like for a lot of you guys, it is most definitely a firm foundation. Maybe there's something in regards to family that you possibly, you know, are looking back, possibly with regrets. But your main focus is possibly on fixing what you can and building a firm foundation, okay? Give me a message for Geminis, please. All right, I saw that at the bottom of the deck. Okay, so we got Queen of Cups. Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio's energy, but nonetheless, very nurturing energy. Very loving energy. Okay, very understanding energy. At the bottom of the deck, we got the King of Wands and the Ten of Swords. Okay, so there could be a fire sign involved, but it's like someone's not taking action. And maybe someone isn't being showing any emotions, or there's a lack of emotions. But nonetheless, the Queen of Cups energy is very nurturing, very loving energy, okay? So maybe you're carrying this type of energy, okay? Maybe that's a change that you want to make as far as energy-wise, okay? We got the Seven of Pentacles. Seven of Pentacles, okay? So this is about planting those seeds. This is about waiting, okay? Being patient. I feel like some of you guys are focused on, you know, your finances, your money, your family, long term, okay? Because we got the Queen of Swords right there behind that, you guys' energy. So this is very serious energy, okay? If you guys were planting seeds in 2019, you're ready to see a harvest, you're ready to see growth, expansion, okay? So why is this the energy? Why is Queen of Cups the energy for this Geminis? Why is this happening? All right, we got the Emperor. Aries is energy. But see, they got two totally different energies here. The Queen of Cups is very compassionate, loving, caring, nurturing, while the Emperor, which is the Father card, okay? This is the Father of the Tarot. He's more demanding, okay? He's more demanding. So this is two separate energies here. You could be dealing with an Aries, okay? But someone here could have possibly been a little controlling in the past, okay? This could be involving family here with this Ten of Pentacles here. Or some of you guys could be dealing with the boss, someone at work. This could be work-related. But most definitely two separate energies, okay? I'm getting like a nice side and a not-so-nice side. The challenge is someone being patient and waiting. Oh, whoa, okay, we got the Devil card wanting to fly out. Capricorn's energy. Wow. Wow. Quite a few, three people here could be. This is Capricorn. But this is like forward movement, forward action, okay? But this could have been saying that there is possibly some type of obsession or possessiveness. Okay, or an addiction, codependency. This could also be some type of negative energy, okay, that someone possibly needs to move on from, okay? What's crowning this? Okay, we got two things that want to pop out. We got the King of Pentacles. Lots of people here. King of Pentacles, Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn's energy. Okay, and then we have the Ten of Swords. So there's an ending. And I definitely did sense that there is a closing of a chapter coming in for you guys. But there's lots of people here. And I'm getting like, you know, someone's fighting for nothing or is feeling like they're fighting for nothing here. We gotta get some clarifiers. Why is this Emperor here? I'm getting like grown man, or you're waiting for someone to grow up. Maybe someone's been misbehaving and there's a cutoff here. Why is the Emperor here? Someone's very controlling though. Very demanding, or you know. Okay, I'm definitely getting like a husband, a boss, someone of authority, okay? We got the Emperor and the Four of Wands. This could be someone that you're married to. For some of you guys, there's a living situation. You're living with someone, husband energy. This could be a work energy, a boss, okay? It's like waiting for to see what someone is going to say. Why is the Seven of Pentacles here? Knight of Swords. And the Ten of Pentacles keep popping out. For some of you guys, this is family or work related, okay? I'm getting like waiting to make a move, waiting to see if someone is going to rush to you, or waiting for you to rush to them. It's like coming towards someone, going to someone's home. Maybe there's a marriage involved here, but I'm getting like man of the house energy, okay? Why is the devil here? Oh, wow. There's lots of toxic energy here that someone needs to move on from. So you guys possibly decided that this is too much confusion. I'm getting the hell out of here. Seven of Cups and the Six of Swords. It's too much going on here. Look at this. Devil and the Five of Wands. It's too much negative. Too much negativity around here. I gotta go. I gotta go. Can't be around this. Why is the King of Pentacles here? Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn energy. Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn's energy. King of Pentacles. Wheel of Fortune. Okay, so there's some changes that possibly need to be made. Okay, I'm getting like changing the rules. There could be a Libra involved. I'm getting that there needs to be some type of change. Okay, Ten of Swords energy. Ten of Swords for future energy. Something is getting cut off. Somebody is getting cut off, but something is definitely over and done with. Okay, you've closed that chapter. Ten of Swords. Why is Ten of Swords here? Why is Ten of Swords here? Oh, Nine of Pentacles. So something is in it and someone is deciding to be single or do something by themselves. Okay, someone is focused on themselves. Someone possibly has more options. Okay, you guys probably got a few different options. Okay, so or you're waiting to make some type of decision or you're waiting for something better to come along. Okay, it's what I'm picking up on. Why is the Queen of Cups here? Some of you guys could be dealing with the water sign or you're carrying this energy. Okay. Why is the Queen of Cups here? It's like a nice, sweet energy. Queen of Cups. Yeah. Someone's asking something nicely. Maybe you guys are asking somebody nicely. Waiting for their type. Waiting to see what their response is going to be. Waiting to see if someone is going to change up something. Because in the past, they could have been really, really mean and negative. There could have been some arguments, some disagreements in the past. But somebody has decided, you know what? I'm cutting that off. I can do this by myself. I don't have time for all that. Why is the Nine of Pentacles here? I'm definitely getting like asked nicely. Nine of Pentacles. Yeah, Eight of Pentacles. So someone's going to be cutting something off and deciding that, look, I can work on this myself. I could do this myself. I don't have to, you know, feed into this. I don't like your actions. I don't like how you do things. I don't like some. You guys don't like how something is being done. So you guys are like, you know what? I don't have to deal with it. I've asked you nicely before to change some things here. And all it did get us to where we're being negative towards each other and arguing. So guess what? I'm just going to cut everything off. And I'm going to work by myself or work on this myself. I can get this done. Let's see what messages the angels have for you. For January 2020. What message is there for Geminis? January 2020. What message is there for Geminis? January 2020. January 2020 for Geminis. What message? All right, we have Easy Does It, Geminis. Your health, happiness, and abundance require a gentle approach to life and work. Okay, so like I said, for some of you guys, you could be dealing with some issues in regards to work. Like this could have been work related, because I did pick up it was a few different energies around you. Okay, Spirit is saying, you know, Easy Does It. Don't stress about this too much. It could be affecting your health, your happiness, and your abundance. So everything that you're dealing with is going to require a gentle approach. Okay, at the bottom of the deck, Spirit is also asking you to grab Charite for spiritual protection. You are being watched over and protected physically, emotionally, and energetically. Okay, so The way that you spell this crystal is charoite, and it looks kind of like it looks like amethyst. It looks like exactly like amethyst, but this here is for spiritual protection, okay? And I feel like spirit is calling for you to protect yourself, okay, spiritually, because this could be affecting your health, okay? If God did sense as well that there's a lot of negativity in your past, that I do sense that you're ready to let go of, okay? You're ready to close that chapter. You're ready to be done with that. I feel like you guys need to ease it out a little bit, okay? Ease it out, because it could be affecting other areas of your life, okay? All right, so I hope that these messages resonated with you guys. If this message did, make sure to hit the thumbs up. Let me know what's going on in the comment section below. Don't forget to share with your family and your friends. And until next time, my loves, ciao for now.